Well, friends, we have the extreme honor of having Lucy Libido on the show today. Welcome. I can't believe we have you here.
I'm super excited. I love talking with my friends.
I'm so pumped. I told Haley, we should have Lucy Libido on. I wonder if she would come on. And when you emailed me back, I was like squealing, like I got a first date or something. She said yes. So thank you.
Absolutely. I'm excited to be with you guys today.
Okay. So tell me a little bit about yourself. Who is Lucy Libido? How did Lucy Libido come to be?
Great question. So several years ago, I was teaching oil classes and I thought, wow, we should teach an oil class for Valentine's Day for couples to help couples to really reunite their relationships and focus on using oils for improving things emotionally, spiritually, and sensually in the bedroom. And so I thought, all right, where do I find the information on this? And I looked and looked and there was no information that even existed on the topic. And so I thought, well, I've got two choices here. I can either say there's no information on this, I can't teach this class, or I'm going to have to go and research and create that information myself. And so that's what I did. I said, okay, I'm going to figure this out. We opened up a research group of several women. We had lots of backgrounds, demographics. We had different races, genders, ages. Some people were married and divorced. Some people were pregnant. Some were going through menopause. So we got a really diverse group of women together. And I gave them homework. I said, okay, let's try this oil for this. Let's try this oil for that. And we did that for several months where we were doing homework. And then I opened up a class to teach, just thinking that this would be for my own group, my own oil group. I opened up a class, but the one caveat we had was that, all of these women, they were really sharing a lot of vulnerable details about their bodies, their husbands' bodies, their relationships, because we talked about all the crap. We talked about what wasn't working, the baggage, the blocks, the things that were not happening that we wanted to happen. And we came up with a lot of solutions, but the women, and even more so the men, were saying, you're not going to do this tonight as homework. And then you're just going to go post about it on the internet in the morning. They all wanted a certain level of anonymity. And so I said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to teach this class under an avatar and no one will know who I am. Therefore, no one will know who you are. But what we can do is we can help people that have similar stories, similar problems and backgrounds. And I will teach under the name Lucy Libido. And so nobody's identity will be out there on the internet as we're talking about these problems and these solutions that we're coming up with. So people were like, great, awesome. So we opened up the group Lucy Libido and it just went viral. It was huge. There were people everywhere trying to get in. I didn't even know how to moderate a group with that many people. We closed down the class and I was just like, oh my gosh, that was a lot of work. There were people coming from everywhere. And I thought it was a one-time class and I closed that class and said, oh my gosh, that was so much work. I'm so glad I never have to teach that class ever again. final last words.
Right.
So, the next year, I noticed that in a lot of the oil groups, especially the silver and up oil groups, there were leaders saying, hey, how do we get into the Lucy Libido group? I know you have to like have an in, you have to be in a group, you have to be invited by a certain person. How do I make sure people get in? And I was like, people are trying to find my group. It was an event. The first class was an event. So it actually disappeared because it was the first time I had really taught online. Mm-hmm. And people were trying to find a group and there was no group and everyone was looking for it. And I thought, well, if anyone's going to open a group, it's got to be me, right? And then I opened my Lucy Libido Facebook account, which I had made for the year prior to teach with that level of anonymity for both myself and my team. And I found that my message box was full of messages. And they were women saying things like, thank you so much for your class. I thought my marriage was over, but we fixed things in the bedroom. And now we're finally connecting again. And it has saved our marriage. Thank you so much. And oh my gosh, after my hysterectomy, I thought I would never work again. And I'm finally working again. And I feel like myself again. And thank you. I was so angry all the time, but it was my hormones. And I wish every woman knew this. And they said, how do I invite my sister? How do I invite my mom? How do I invite my friend? How do I invite my team? And I realized I have to open this group. People are asking for it. There's a need for it. So I opened a public group this time. And in one day we had 10,000 ads and it's grown to over 100,000 people. And that is where I teach. And I continue to teach under Lucy Libido. We still have a little bit of that anonymity in there. But now that I'm all over now, I'm at Diamond Bound. I teach on the Global Symposium for Audie Wanker every year. I go to rallies all over the United States and Canada and Asia. And I also, I'm always at a convention. So people see me now. So that kind of that secrecy is a little bit because I'm always on the stage, but the information is still there and it's still so much fun and it helps so many women. And it's turned into really a journey and a calling for me that I never knew was my calling until I stepped into it. And now it's just a space that I really love to be helping women.
Yeah, I love that so much. And I think what stood out to me is like the women and men who were like, you're not going to post about this, right? And I think like what we are so insecure about is oftentimes like what so many other people are struggling with. And we think like, it's just me. So no one can know, but it's like, those are the stories that other people connect with the most. And so I love that you were able to share those stories. And then you had, I mean, I was like wanting to cry when you were saying the messages you were getting.
Yes. I was crying. Yeah. I was like, oh my gosh, I didn't know what an impact I made until I opened my messages and read people's messages again. I just taught and then I closed that account and I didn't even look at a lot of them for, it was almost a year later when I actually read them. And
yeah.
And I think it was the right time because it told me you need to do this.
Yeah.
It was really special. It was a very special moment.
That is so cool. And I love that it's like this, that level of deep helping people, but also like even in my own oil community, I like remember friends being like, have you heard of Lucy Libido book? And like just the giggles and like, so it's just brought like so much fun, if nothing else, like if nothing super deep and vulnerable for people, it's like something really fun to like giggle about with your friends. And it's like, you can be anywhere on that spectrum. I think that's what I love about it so much.
Yeah, it's a real safe space to be because there is a lot of humor. So if you are in that Facebook group or if you follow me on Instagram, but more so in the group when I'm in there live and I'm teaching, I'm cracking a lot of jokes. And we talk about the vulnerable stuff and we talk about the crap and we talk about the blocks and we talk about valuing our self-worth and expecting the partner in our life to value our self-worth. Like we talk about those really deep, hard topics that things don't work and what we need to do to fix them. But we also crack a lot of jokes and we use a lot of innuendo. I have a whole entire language. And if you've been in my group, you know, like what all this fun language is. There's a lot of laughter in our group. So if anything, come into the group and follow me and come to my events. If you want to laugh, I like to laugh too. And I love to laugh together.
Yes. I love that. I was supposed to go to like a local Lucy Libido class that someone was teaching and I got sick and my friend went and she was just texting me all of your words and just like under the table, she's texting me different things and I'm like sick cracking up. So it's definitely just so much fun. So many laughs. Okay. So
yeah, it is super fun.
Yeah. So that Facebook group and realization that you were really doing something brought, how did that come about to become your book?
Great question. So the first year that I opened up the group, so originally the very first class was an event and it disappeared and people were panicking and trying to get in. That's when I opened the messages and went, oh, I need to open up something that's like permanent, that's going to stay, which became the group. Then I was teaching in that group and I noticed a lot of people were like, oh, can I take a screenshot? I need to write this down. I want this information because we had so much posts and we had so much content and people were saying, I really need like a guide. I need this in writing because there's so much content and information here. And it's hard, as you know, on Facebook, things get bumped and things get moved around. It's hard to get all the content in a Facebook forum where things move around. And a lot of people were asking me to put it in writing. And kind of, I reached the same fork in the road of, okay, I don't really know how to write a book. I don't know how to professionally do all the things that go into making a book, but people are asking for this in a written form. And the best way to do that is to make a book. So what do I do? And again, I figure out how to write, edit, produce, publish a book, or I don't. And so I said, okay, I'm going to figure out how to do this. And that is how Lucy Libido Says There Is an Oil for That was born. And little subtitle there, A Girlfriend's Guide to Using Essential Oils Between the Sheets. And it was definitely a labor of love. It was definitely an experience of feeling forward, because my first edition was like massively bad because I had an editor who was not the right choice and edited and changed a lot of words in ways that were incorrect and did not make sense. And the book was hilariously bad. And I immediately pulled it when I found out there was a lot of things I didn't know that there were problems with it. And I immediately pulled it and like 1,000 copies went out. And we actually call it the limited edition, Naval edition, because there were, and if you got one, it's like actually now almost like a rare commodity, because it was the first bad batch before I cut it and fixed it and then we put it out there. And it was just it was an experience of like, oh my gosh, it is hard to edit a book. It is hard to catch mistakes. It's hard to get everything right. But I mean, I learned and I feel for it. I learned how to publish. I did the design on the cover and then I sent it to a designer to actually make it in the files that were correct for books, because I didn't know how to do files, but I designed everything. I wrote everything, found great people who were good team members to help with the technical side of it. And now if I need to put out something new, I've got a great team who I know who I can trust. But it's like anything, the first time you do something, you don't know how to do it. And you just try and either it works out or it doesn't. And then you try again. So it was definitely that experience. But the fun thing was when we put it in print, that group was like 10, 12,000 people at the time. And I was writing the book while I was teaching the class, and I was just working 18 hours a day trying to get this to the people in the group that were asking for it. I was really trying to meet a need. There were people asking for it. I was trying to meet that need. And I think that's why it was so successful. And I didn't have a website. I didn't have a publisher. I didn't have a warehouse. I had none of that. I just had a Facebook group where I was teaching at the time. And I finished publishing the book and I said, guess what, friends? I know you want the content in book form. I have the book. It's right here. And I just had like this one page website with PayPal information at the time. And I said, if you want a book, PayPal me the information with your address and I'll send it to you. And my husband was like, oh my gosh, you put so much time and money into this book. I really hope you break even, because it was a considerable investment to bring it to print, as is any project. And he said, you know, is this going to go into your downline? Is this going to help your OGD? And I said, honestly, no, it's not, because I have followers from all around the world and no one, it's not going to impact my OGD. Mm-hmm. And he said, then why are you doing it? And I said, because people are asking for it. And they want the information. And I'm the only person that can give it is Lucy Libido. And so I'm going to give it to the people who are asking, whether or not they're in my downline. If there's a need, I will fill it. Mm-hmm. So we put the book out and my PayPal account, we started seeing people putting in orders and we're like, yay. And I was like, oh, good. Actually, more than 5 people are going to buy this book. That's kind of cool. You know. And then it kind of kept going up again. And I was like, oh my gosh. Mr. Libido, we broke even. Like all of the costs we put into this, like we are not in the red. That's super cool. And he's like, okay, that's good to know. You know, you know, man. And then, you know, we turned it off. We went to bed. We woke up the next morning and I logged into my PayPal account and my jaw just hit the floor. And I said, Mr. Libido, he's like, what? I said, we need to learn how to hire a shipping company. We had sold 8,000 books overnight. Oh, and I was shipping them from my kitchen table. Like I didn't even know how to do it. And so it took us weeks to get it out. And after that, I just gave it to Amazon because I was like, I don't have shipping capabilities. PayPal or Amazon does. I'm like, Amazon, just take it, because I can't literally, I would ship books all day long. I can't do this. I gave it to Amazon. They accepted me as an author. But they put it up on their site and then it became the number one best-selling book in essential oils on Amazon. It just flew to the top. Thousands of people were buying a day and it just went viral. And from there, just groups teach with it. It's been a wild ride because I had no idea how much need there was for it, but it taught me something, taught me a couple of things. One was that whenever you feel a need, that's going to come back to you. You always have to fill people's needs. And there was a need. And the reason why I think it did well was because I was filling that need. And then to just trust feeling forward, not being perfect, not having the answers. I put it out before I had a shipping company. And then I learned when I needed one. So, you know, it was like, I felt like it was kind of like you're jumping off a ledge and you're growing your wings as you go, because it was so fast and so unexpected the way it grew so quickly. But then I had to learn. I had to learn how to moderate massively large groups. I had to learn how to have shipping production. I had to get a website set up. I had to learn how to take credit cards, because there was that need for that.
Yeah.
But all the things I learned as I went. I was not a marketer with all of these tools in my toolbox. I was a girl at my kitchen counter telling a story that somebody else could relate to and somebody else needed in their life. And that is what it grew from. So that's how it turned into the massively popular book. And it is so fun. You can grab it at lucylibido.com. Obviously, it's also on Amazon too.
I'm yeah. Yes, it is amazing. I have it right here. And it is so good. And I feel like we should, for friends who are just listening, we are both holding our books up on our, you know, little Zoom. Okay. So it is so good. And I feel like some essential oil, like references are just, I read them and I'm just like, okay, cool. I don't know what I just read. Like, this is so sciencey that I don't even understand. And the way you write, mind-blowing in the sciencey sense, but it's not too crazy to like wrap your mind around. And I love that so much. You did such a great job. So highly recommend. And it is like, I was giggling reading it. Like, it's so much fun. So I just adore it. So something before we dive in, I'm sure listeners are like, talk about sex and oils. get to the good stuff. But I want to talk about something that you talk about in the beginning of the book, which I absolutely loved. And that was feeling sexy.
Yes.
Because I really like, I was just nodding my head along while I was reading of like, it is this being and feeling sexy feels often like this small box that like, I don't have a seat in. Mm-hmm. And so it's hard to even get in the headspace or, you know, feel or even think I ever could feel sexy or be sexy. So can you kind of talk about like, what is sexy and what are the voices in our heads and all of that?
Oh, yes. Thank you. This was one of my favorite things that I wrote in the book. And I put it in the beginning because I think it is the foundation for a healthy relationship, mm-hmm. is knowing and understanding your own beauty and worth, and that it's deeper than just one very small box, as you say, of like what maybe a commercial image of what beauty is, or, you know, what that can look like. And this came from our actual research group. It was so, so eye-opening. I was giving these women all these exercises and these homework assignments, you know, do this and do that, and do this and do that. And I gave one homework assignment that just nobody would turn in. No one would do it. And I kept reminding and saying, oh, remember to do this one. Remember to do that one. And it just, people weren't doing it. And you would think that it was like, oh my gosh, what kind of an act was she asking these people to do that they would not turn in this one assignment of our research homework? But do you know what that assignment was? It was to write down 10 things about yourself that are beautiful. That, out of everything I gave my women to do, was the thing that people were reluctant and took forever and really had to think about and just would not get it back to me. And that was eye-opening to me.
Yeah.
I thought, why is that so hard? Why are we so reluctant? Why does that really make us stop to pause and be like, gosh, I got to think on that for a few days? And I realized that it is sometimes ingrained in us that we're not allowed to say, I'm beautiful because of this. I'm confident because of that. I'm great because of that. Like, there might be voices that say like, oh, that is selfish, or that is conceited, or that is egotistical. And no, egotistical is when you believe that you are superior and better than another person. And that is not a good trait to have. But knowing your value your worth, your beauty, and seeing that in yourself is confidence. And I believe that love starts from within, that we have to love ourselves first, that if we don't already recognize our worth and our beauty, that we don't have the ability to give and receive love, because it's a two-way street. Mm-hmm. And if you can't see that in yourself, you are not going to have the open ability to receive love in the way that you deserve and in the way that you are meant to. So I always start with talking about your inner beauty, writing down things about yourself that's beautiful. And when you put that pen to paper, it is beautiful how you realize, oh, I am beautiful because I'm empathetic or kind or thoughtful, or because I work hard, or because I have passion, or because I have drive, or because I'm individualistic. Whatever it is that you see in yourself, or that your spouse or partner sees in you that makes you beautiful, when you put that to paper, it brings something out in women. And it is in the book To Write In Your Book. It is also in our little black book, which is the teacher's edition. So we have a teacher's guide for teachers to teach the classes, like you were mentioning, that, you know, your friend went to a Lucy Libido class. So we have a teacher's guide that teaches you how to teach the class. And that is the first exercise we do in there. Because in order to have a healthy, loving relationship, there has to be two people that value you, love you, and see your self-worth. And that two people, one is your partner. Your partner has to value, love you, and see your worth, or you're not going to have a sexual or healthy, intimate relationship. But also that other person is you. You have to value yourself and see your own worth and your own beauty in order to receive and have that healthy relationship. So that is critical to that emotional aspect of intimacy, which I believe is a core of healthy and amazing relationships and amazing sex and intimacy, is that that emotional connection is there, and that ability to have that open heart of giving and receiving openly without shame is critical.
Yeah. And I love that that's in the beginning. Cause like you said, like setting those foundational blocks of like, this has to come first. I love that. So what about for listeners who are like, okay, great, but I don't feel sexy at all. How can we like work towards that?
That is such a great question. And again, I think it comes to putting pen to paper, asking your partner. If you can't figure it out yourself, ask your partner, ask your friends. Hey, why do you like me as a friend? Hey, why do you love me? And that's kind of reaching out to pull in. That's a good place to start. Your spouses and your friends are probably going to say things like, you're fun. You are tolerant. You are kind. You accept me the way I am. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, you're good at this or that. And then you can take those. And I tell people in the book that if you don't believe it, you have to actually say it out loud so that your conscious and your subconscious connects. And so I say to write down those things about yourself that are beautiful. And if you need to start with other people's words, you start with other people's words. You will eventually come to a place where they will become your own words. And you say it every day and you say it in the mirror. I am beautiful because of this. I am worthy because of this. And the more you say it consciously, the more your subconscious will internalize it. And the more your internal belief system will change, that you actually believe those things that maybe you didn't believe before.
Yes. So true. And I remember hearing, I don't even remember what book it was, but oftentimes things that we really, really admire in other people are like hidden treasures within ourselves. I think too, like maybe it would be like, what's sexy to you about other people? And not like Hollywood's definition of sexy, but like truly like your bestie. What about her is like sexy? And like, I think that is so true, that often, because even personality traits, like I love people that can make me laugh. And then when I look inward, like I love to make people laugh. And so I think like it definitely, they go hand in hand so much. Okay, so let's get to it. Oils for libido, intimacy, between the sheets, however you want to say it, friends, we're going to talk about it. I think a lot of people are probably like, how do you use essential oils between the sheets? Because I mean, that's how I felt using them, period, when I first started. So you use them the same three ways, right? Aromatically, topically, and internally. But can you kind of give us the deep dive of each one and how you go about doing so?
Exactly. So, well, in our research group, we figured out the best oils for intimacy in general. We've got a whole book and list, and we'll go into a few of them. It would be like, we'd be talking for hours if we went to every single one. But yes, we break it down to the simple thing. You're going to use them the same way. You put them in your diffuser, and then it's going to bring those aphrodisiac qualities when you walk in a room and the room smells a certain way. Topically on your skin, there are certain oils that are going to support lubrication, or they're going to support progesterone levels, or they're going to support testosterone levels, or they're going to support firmness in your man. There are oils that work with our body for our natural body functions to ameliorate them. Mm-hmm. So absolutely, you can use them topically. And then oils that are generally regarded as safe for consumption, the acronym is GRASS. We say an oil is GRASS. You can use that internally as a supplement. And that can supplement and support your body in those ways too. So one thing I always like to make really clear when you're using essential oils between the sheets is that obviously the parts of the body that we're talking about are more sensitive. We never put oils neat, especially spicy or hot oils, on sensitive membranes. Anything that you're not going to put directly into your eye or near your eye, you're not going to put like down south under the hood of the car. Mm-hmm. So, if you're talking about like thieves or peppermint or light the fire, please know, friends, like you're not going to use those oils neat. The book has recipes where they're diluted into proper lubes and love potions that make it so that they're very effective, but they're not going to be too strong or too spicy. So whenever you're using an essential oil between the sheets or in the bedroom, I always recommend putting it in a roller bottle with some fractionated coconut oil and then using it as a love potion that you roll on. Or you put it in a lube blend where then you use it as a lube so that you're not putting things on straight. Now, some oils, if you're putting them on your wrists or your ankles, yeah, you can use those neat, but you just want to be very mindful that anything that is caustic with like eugenol, like clove or cinnamons, or menthol, like peppermints, that you're not going to be using those near sensitive areas. And then with any essential oil, you always want to test first on your forearm. I always say, here's the rule, forearm before foreskin. And especially the men, they're like, well, I don't have a foreskin. And I'm like, but you understand what I'm talking about. Yes. Okay. So forearm before foreskin. Like I would never say to take an oil that you've never used on your body anywhere and then just like put it somewhere, down. Yeah. The well, absolutely. Make sure that you're putting it on your forearm first. It's very rare to have major problems using an oil, but the last thing you want to do is find out that you're somewhat allergic to Sutrin after you put it, down on the trunk of the tree. Please use your essential oils on your forearm first and dilute. You can always go up. It's always hard to go down.
Yeah.
But so essential oils can be used in those ways. You just have to be cautious that you're diluting them appropriately. And if you're brand new and you're like, I have no idea how to dilute, just grab the Lucy book. There's recipes in there. If you follow those, they're absolutely foolproof.
Yes. Okay. That was such a good rundown. So, and also in the Lucy book, she shares, you guys, so many oils that can be used. So before our interview, I'm like flipping through trying to pick, and then I'm like, I'll have Lucy pick for me. So if you could pick top five that people listening need to try out between the sheets, what would they be?
Okay, this is hard because I have him and her, but I'll give a couple for her. Oh, yeah. I'll give a couple for him. And again, there's so many more. It's just like, that is so hard. But for women, I would say it's always important to support in the bedroom healthy lubrication levels. Mm-hmm. And oils like clary sage are amazing for that. Mm-hmm. So I call clary sage the lubing oil because it has high levels of phytoestrogens, which are bioavailable in your body, and they're similar to human estrogens, and they support lubrication of your eyes and also downstairs. So I have rollers in there called Juicy Lucy, and they all have clary sage in them. And you can use clary sage on your wrists, over your ovaries, around your belly button, below your navel, and your inner thighs. And that really helps to support that process in a woman, which obviously makes everything better. I always say it's never fun to go down a dry water slide like that. Okay. You definitely want a little water on your slide. So yes. Clarity Sage is fantastic for that. So I love that for women. Another oil that I love for women is Progestence Plus. It's technically a serum because it's a blend, but it's a blend that supports healthy progesterone levels. And progesterone is very heavily tied to libido. So Progestins Plus, for those of you who are new to oils, is a blend that is a balance, it's a hormone balancing blend oil. And depending on your age, I say if you're in your 30s, wear it the week before your period. If you're in your 40s, I would say it, wear it every single day or 40s and up, because it's so fantastic at keeping healthy progesterone levels, which is going to help with things like PMS, with anger, with low libido. That's a fantastic oil to balance hormones. Depending on your cycle, I don't always recommend it to wear it the week you're menstruating, just because it will tend to lengthen your period. However, women who have really heavy periods, for example, some women that may have endometriosis, if they have very, very heavy periods, they actually like to wear Progestins Plus through their period because it makes it lighter and longer versus like heavier and shorter. Think of progesterone is your holding hormone. That is actually the hormone that holds your uterus. And it's the hormone that retains pregnancy, which is why if women have lots of miscarriages, one of the first things their doctors are going to look at is, hey, what are your progesterone levels? Because in a healthy natural pregnancy, your progesterone levels go up 200% when you're pregnant. And then when they drop is when you go into labor. So as we cycle, our progesterone level goes up about mid-month, and then through as we get towards our period, they drop very low. And then that is when we shed, and then that's when we have our period. Hmm. Now, the issue with too low a progesterone is if your levels drop too low as you come up to menstruation, that's when you tend to have more hormonal headaches, migraines, PMS, anger, anxiety, because that hormone is also a hormone that regulates your mood. So that's why that drop is also related to PMS. So you can manage that drop such that you drop enough to menstruate still. It's not going to stop your menstruation, but it's going to prevent you from going what I call is like the line of insanity. So you've got like this healthy line and we do this and we come here when we menstruate, but it doesn't tank so low that we feel emotionally out of control. Mm-hmm. So it's a fantastic oil. That's why I love to use it up before my period, because that's when you're naturally dropping. But if you feel like it's making your period really, really long, it's just because it's a holding hormone. It's telling your body, you know, don't shed, although you would have to use a lot of, I've never known someone to not have a period using Progestins Plus, but it's going to make it a little lighter is what it's going to do. So lighter you might want if you have a heavy period, but if you have a light period, lighter means you're probably going to spot for longer on both ends. So you know your own body. You're going to use oils with your body. You're going to figure out what you like. One woman's going to like it all the time. Another woman is going to use it a week before. One woman, you know, everyone's going to be different, but that's how it works to support that hormone. The great thing about Progestins Plus is because your hormone levels are more regulated and they're not dropping so heavy towards your cycle, is that's going to help so much with your libido and your mood. So I tell women to use that as an oil to just manage your cycle, but also to use it in the bedroom because it absolutely supports mood. So it's a fantastic one to put on morning and night if you know you're planning a date with your lover that night.
Yes. And it smells like, I can't even describe it, but it smells so
good. It's got a little bit of a mint in it, but it's not super minty. It's a nice smell. So those are a couple of my favorite oils for her.
Okay.
Talk about a couple of my favorite oils for him, for in the bedroom. One of my favorite oils for him, and this, when I started teaching about this, it was always going out of stock. I think I caught up a little bit more. But I love Idaho Blue Spruce for men in the bedroom. Idaho Blue Spruce supports healthy testosterone levels in him. So, you know, for those of our listeners who are above 18 and have a partner in their life, testosterone is definitely going to support him in the bedroom to be have what we call a strong and firm and standing soldier. So I always say Idaho Blue Spruce. Spruce is your soldier to stand at attention, because nobody wants a slouching soldier. You know they would get kicked out of the line, right?
Yeah.
They gotta be stalwart and they gotta be saluting and they cannot get weak. And yes. I love Idaho Blue Spruce for that. And that's one that you can use in, internally. I should go back there. It is generally regarded as safe for consumption. However, it's not yet in the vitality line, but it is generally regarded as safe for consumption. So we don't have printed directions to use as a supplement, but it is generally regarded as safe. So if that's something that you choose to do, you can take that internally if you choose to take based on it being grass. And then you absolutely can use that topically. That is a great oil to use in a man lube. And people ask me, oh my gosh, like, how is my husband going to let me just like put this on him? I promise you, he's not going to complain if you give him an Idaho Blue Spruce massage. I've never had one person message me or email me complaining about their Idaho Blue Spruce massage.
Yeah.
So something you definitely can dilute, and you can put that, like, just think of like you're out in the forest. You are playing with your lover out in the forest, and you're going to take that out of the spruce, and you're going to put it all around the boulders, and you're going to rub that in, you know, a little bit of those crevices of those hills. And you definitely, you can even rub that generously up the trunk of the tree. You can go all those places. I just say to be aware to maybe avoid the eye of the one-eyed snake, because we don't put essential oils in our eyes, even snake eyes.
Yeah.
Other than that, you pretty much can have a lot of fun with that. And again, the men, they love it. So a good Idaho Blue Spruce massage is a super fun way to spice up your bedroom. And that love is that. I love for him. And then another oil that I love for him is nutmeg. Nutmeg is a, it's kind of underappreciated in the bedroom, but it is a stimulant, and nutmeg supports the adrenal glands, which is what gives us energy, endorphins, and it actually acts a lot like caffeine in the body. So you don't want to go crazy with it. I say, you know, one or two drops is all you need of nutmeg. Dilute that down because it is a little bit spicy, but you only need one or two drops to make any kind of a lube or a love potion. Just amazing. And it gives him a lot of energy. It gives sexual energy. It helps with healthy vasodilation. So vasodilation is the dilation of vessels. So again, for my listeners who are over 18 years old, having dilated vessels is very important for your man if you want to have a good show, you know, at the end of your date. So nutmeg is a great oil, and that is one that you can use internally, and that is one that you can use topically with dilution. Make sure you don't use more than one or two drops. Otherwise, it can be so stimulating that it can act like caffeine for some people. So again, use in moderation, dilute, amazing in small amounts. You don't need a lot.
Okay.
So those are a few of my favorite oils for him and her topically. And you said five. Let me think of one more. I'm going to say diffuser, because those are all topical blends.
Oh, yes.
Diffuser blends. Well, I'm going to have to give you more than one, but yes. I love oils in the diffuser that really set the mood with aphrodisiac aromas. So ylang ylang is an amazing aphrodisiac. Absolutely gets you in the mood. And it's very floral. So I prefer to tone down that floral aroma with either some cypress, which makes it a little bit more woody and smooth, or a little bit of orange, which makes it a little bit more citrusy. I also love the combination of blue cypress and jasmine in the diffuser. Those are very romantic smelling oils. Blue cypress smells a little bit like sandalwood. It's a viscous oil. And then the jasmine is just so lovey. If you guys aren't so new that you didn't win jasmine was just given away recently with the Bora Bora dream oils. Jasmine was one of those dream oils. And I got that, and I'm just super stoked to have a nice new fresh bottle of jasmine, because I love jasmine and blue cypress in the diffuser.
I have to try that, because I've had blue cypress, but I was like, what do I use this for? I think I must have won it or something. And I'm always like, I don't know what to use this
for. Blue cypress was a promo in the last year. And blue cypress is one of my favorite oils. Again, underappreciated. It is very romantic smelling. It's high in sesquiterpenes like sandalwood. It's viscous like sandalwood, which really helps to oxygenate, support oxygenation in the brain. And putting that in the diffuser is just so zen and good for your mind to calm and relax. And then you put the jasmine in there. It's so romantic.
Ooh, I love that. I was trying so hard because I know that I have a microphone in front of my face. I was trying so hard not to like lose it cracking up because I knew listeners wouldn't then be able to hear you. But this is so fun. I hope people are like giggling away in their cars or wherever they're listening from. So fun. When you said like, pretend you and your lover are having like a date in the forest, I was like, I'll never be able to smell that again without thinking like I'm on a date in the forest.
I'll look around wearing nothing but leaves.
Yes. Okay. Since we're whimsy and wellness, would you share like your favorite DIY recipe?
Oh, my favorite DIY recipe, hands down, is the Libido Love Button Stroking Jelly, which absolutely does what it sounds like. It is a jelly for love button stroking, and it's incredible. And it's brought women back from women who are like, I'm in my 60s. I thought I was done. And they're like, I'm 20 again. That's amazing. So it's a jelly blend. So it's a lube. And then it has sensation, joy, orange, and just a teeny bit of peppermint in there. Again, not so much that it's going to be crazy. It's like one drop, but it's in a lube base of several tablespoons of lube. And so it gives this tingling sensation that is like highway to heaven. It's incredible.
Oh my goodness. Okay. And that's in your book, right?
It is. It is. It's in the
okay.
book.
There but are
it's
so
my many. Number one most popular recipe. We also have these really cute guest note folios. If you teach a Lucy Libido class, you can get the little black book, which is a teacher's manual. And it comes with coordinating little notebooks, a little notebook card for guests. They're like 60 cents each per guest. They're so affordable. And it has that recipe on the back too, because it has a make and take. So you can teach a class and then you turn it over and there's a make and take recipe. And then you can go make and take with your little posse there. And then you can all take home like a little sample and use it with your husband. And when you do that, it's pretty hilarious, Megan, because then that next morning, all the husbands are like, what's that essential rewards program? So we never run out of these again. Yeah. We apparently need 10 more oils that I didn't know about. Like if you want to get a man on essential rewards, you just send his wife home with love button stroke and jelly to try at home.
That is so strategic. I love that. And there are so many recipes in this book, you guys, like I'm telling you, there are so many recipes. So, and if you have like a friend getting married and you're wanting to give some DIY gifts, make her.
It's a fun book to give away for like wedding or bachelorette parties.
Yes.
It's a fun book to give when someone gets an oil kit. Book to give away for Valentine's Day. We have a special Valentine's Day box. So this episode is going to come out at the end of February. Mm-hmm. And if we're not sold out, we have a special Valentine's Day box that has the book in it and a deck of cards, but the deck of cards will stay even if the box is gone. We have a really fun Valentine's Day special, which is a deck of cards, and it's called Tattoo My Heart. And it comes with gold tattoos that you put like on your neck or your thigh or your ankle or your chest. And then it's got playing cards that coordinate with all of the Lucy Libido oils. And so it tells you to put this oil on this part of your body and do this and that. It's super fun. You get all the oils in you that is going to make your night amazing. And then as you go through your deck and you're putting down your cards and you get to that tattoo, when you hit that tattoo, then I say game is over. The card game ends and then the loving begins. So it's a really fun date night game.
Yes.
And right now for Valentine's Day, they're coming in a bundle, but you can get them separately too. So if you already have a Lucy book, you can still get the card deck for February, but even for any time of the year. It's a fun game. It's a way to spice things up. It's fun for weddings. It's fun for bachelorettes, fun for anniversaries. If you're like, okay, we've been married so many years, let's get something fun for us for our anniversary. This card deck is so fun. So we have so many ways to make it so fun for you over at the website, lucylibido.com.
Yay. And they can join your Facebook group, correct? And what is that, just Lucy Libido if they search it on Facebook?
Yep. You should be able to find it if you search Facebook. If not, here's the link. It's super secret. Facebook.com/groups/LucyLibidoSays. So if you can remember that, that will take you directly to my group. We moderate that group very heavily. We ask you questions that say, hey, where did you find us from? As long as you answer the questions, you get right on in. If you don't answer the questions, you probably will not, because we keep it a safe, organic space for our women. So all you need to do is say, when it says, hey, how did you hear about me? Just say, hey, I heard about you on the Whimsy and Wellness podcast. We see that you're in. So just make sure you answer those moderation questions.
Amazing. This has been so fun. I hope people have learned something. I've learned something. I want to go like diffuse and all of the things. can you, or actually we have rapid fire questions.
Oh, okay.
Are you ready?
I'm so ready.
Okay. Number one, fill in the blank. I'm inspired by
oils.
I love that. I love that that was the first thing that came to mind. Two, something you wish you could tell your younger self.
It's okay to fail forward.
That is such a good one. I wish we could learn that way younger, for sure. Your nighttime guilty pleasure snack.
A real one or the one that I wish? I would usually say a piece of chocolate, but it's usually a bowl of cereal.
Why is cereal so good at night?
It's because it's fast and easy and you're hungry. You don't want to like make a mess. Yeah,
I swear it's better at night than
bread. But I do like the Kellogg's Chocolate Delight cereal that has little chocolate nibs in the cereal. That's probably my favorite nighttime cereal. I don't need it in the morning, but tonight it's like it's chocolate and cereal.
Oh, that is so good.
Not healthy at all, but you know, you said guilty pleasure, right?
Yes, exactly. Okay. And then you've pretty much already answered this, but maybe you have a different answer that's not between the sheets. What's your go-to essential oil roller blend?
Roller blend? Mm-hmm. Like for sheets or for every
for
day?
For anything. You're right now, what's your go-to?
I always have a Stress Away roller in my bag because I love that.
Yeah.
It's calming and it smells so great. And I always have a Thieves roller in my bag just because touching icky stuff, I'm always rolling. I roll Thieves on my hands with my roller probably more than I use my hand sanitizer just because I love it. So I love always having those two rollers in my bag at all times.
That's so good. Okay. And then we already went over where listeners can find you, but you have an Instagram, correct? Can you share that?
Yeah. So yeah, it's again, super hard to remember. Instagram/LucyLibido. Perfect. And then Facebook again, Facebook/LucyLibido. The group, which is where I teach and I have a lot of fun, Facebook.com/groups/LucyLibidoSays. And we're also in the process of putting more content on the website, just because sometimes it's hard to find things on Facebook because it moves around. So we're taking a lot of our Facebook content and putting it on the website so it's easier to navigate. And again, that's lucylibido.com. And I have a blog on there with tips. I have a place where you can buy all the fun stuff like the book, the roller bottles, the tattoo aphrodisiac love deck, all that is there. We're going to be putting teaching and educational courses on there soon that we're going to be pulling from Facebook. So you pretty much can get everything one stop at lucylibido.com.
Amazing. I will put that in the show notes for everybody so you can click over. This has been so much fun. I feel like I just hung out with a girlfriend. So thank you for
that's what it's supposed to feel like. It's supposed to feel like sitting around laughing and talking with a good friend.
Yes, we need more laughter, seriously. So thank you. I hope people listening just walk away feeling like excited and empowered and sexy.
Yes, you are beautiful. Absolutely.
Yes. Thank you so much for being on.
Thanks, Meg. And thanks, Whimsy and Wellness. We love your site.